you take the boats out tonight when Daddy comes home?
If he picks up some gas. Those boats are bone dry. Hey, be careful. You've been breathing really heavy lately.
I know. I'll be fine. Got my hair in my pocket.
Thank you.
Good to be home.
Oh, it's good to have you home. 2 weeks is too long.
1 day is too long.
Dad! Dad!
Hey! Come on! Oh! It's only been 2 weeks, but you've grown 3 inches.
Uh-huh. Hey, Daddy is exhausted. Let's get him inside, because what do we do?
We make him dinner.
Dinner!
Let's do this.
Oh, I've been driving for 5 hours straight. A home-cooked meal sounds amazing.
Lord, we thank you so much for our time together. We thank you for our love for each other, which we can only learn through you. And I thank you for watching over my family while I've been gone. Amen.
Wait, God, I just want to thank you for bringing Daddy home. Amen.
Okay. Dig in. You want this first?
Yep. Dad, can we go bowling this weekend?
I don't see why not. The lake's supposed to be smooth as glass.
Mom says there's never any gas in the boats.
Oh, she does, does she?
No, I did not say that. But Daddy has to help Mommy with some chores before we get out on the boat, okay?
Whoa, whoa, whoa. We can do both.
Okay, eat some salad too, please.
Okay.
I know you want this.
I want the meat. Yes. So how's Brandon doing?
He's doing okay. The doctors still don't know what's wrong with him. But the medication that he's on seems to be keeping everything under control, so. Oh, and remember we have the appointment with the genetic specialist tomorrow.
We do?
Yes, Jason, I told you about this appointment at least 2 weeks ago. What?
It's just that I have a meeting scheduled tomorrow.
You just got home.
Yeah, there's a lot of follow-up work after every business trip. You know that.
Tomorrow is the only day that we can see the specialist for the next 3 weeks. I need you there. Brandon needs you there.
Move my 9 a.m. to next week and shift my 11 a.m. slightly.
Thank you.
leave a message after the tone.
Hey, sweetie. I didn't even get a chance to give you a kiss goodbye this morning. I guess you couldn't cancel your appointment. Okay, we'll see you at the doctor. Dr. McCann, 10 a.m. at the hospital, okay? Bye.
Didn't you say Dad was meeting us here?
Yeah, he's gonna be here any second. Jason, hi. Where are you? It's after 10 o'clock. We're at Dr. McCann's office, San Bernardino Hospital, Building 3. Okay?
Dr. McCann is ready to see you.
I'll do the pickup on Monday, and you call me.
I will. Thank you.
You're welcome. See you later. Bye.
Dad's still not home. Where is he?
He's working.
So you talked to him?
Well,
you didn't talk to him.
No, I talked to him. And he just had to leave for a business trip.
How come? How many business trips does he have to go on?
A lot. I mean, he works really hard to take such good care of us. He'll be home in a couple days.
You promise? See, you can't promise. You don't know.
Why don't we go have an hour of free time and then we'll get started on your homework?
It's Friday. Can't I do my homework over the weekend?
Yeah. You can. What about video games? You want to go play some video games?
Sure.
Okay. We'll call Dad later, okay?
All right.
We're still on this thing?
Yep, I'm drawing.
Oh, well, that is very good. But it is time for bed.
He never returned my call, did he? I don't understand. Why is my dad like this?
Look, this is just a season, okay? Once Daddy feels like we're more financially okay, he's gonna settle down and he's gonna stop traveling so much.
When?
Hopefully really soon. I miss him too, you know. I love you.
Love you too, Mom.
Good night.
Good night.
It's me. Can you please call me and let me know where you are? I'm really worried.
Hey, there's nothing to worry about.
Okay.
So worried about you.
What are you worried about? everything. My mind was racing.
You never have to worry about me.
Yes, I do. I'm your wife. Where have you been, anyway?
I was at a dinner meeting in Escondido.
This late?
Yes. I have to meet with people. If I don't meet with people, we don't make money. If we don't make money, we have no houses, no food, no cars, no clothes, all that stuff.
Hi, sis. Thank you for coming over.
Of course. What are sisters for? No word, huh?
No. Hi.
Hi. I'm so mad at him. It's been 24 hours and nothing. I'm literally losing my mind.
That man is always working. Maybe he just had another business meeting and forgot to tell you.
I hope so. But then what's his excuse for missing Brandon's appointment? Or not contacting me for 24 hours?
Have you thought about calling the police?
And saying what? My husband hasn't called me in 24 hours. He didn't come home. What are they gonna do? Nothing.
Well, I'll call the local hospitals and see if he's checked in anywhere.
Hospitals?
Yes, Sarah, what if he had a medical emergency? My friend's husband had a heart attack while getting into his car at the supermarket. He was dead inside of his car for 8 hours before anybody found him.
Lauren!
Sorry, it's just, it's a little morbid, but these things do happen. I'm sure that he's fine. You just have to consider all possibilities.
Yeah. You're right. Could you watch Brandon while I go to the police station?
Yeah, of course. It's a good idea that you're just telling him that he's missing.
Okay, he's not missing. He's just not here.
Hi, my name's Sarah Goodman. I live on Peninsula Lane in Boulder Bay.
Yeah.
It's not really an emergency yet, but I haven't heard from my husband Jason in the last 24 hours.
It's probably a detective.
Sarah? Sarah Brown.
Mr. Sharpson.
Actually, Detective Sharpson.
Hi, I see you've got off the streets.
Well, patrol, it's a young man's game. Solving crime, so it's a little more cerebral, a little less physical. How's your dad? I haven't seen him in years.
You know, unfortunately, my dad passed away a couple years ago.
I am so sorry. He was a great guy.
Yeah, he was.
Yeah, you know, I tried to reach out to him a little while back, and I never heard from him.
Well, you know, my dad had a lot of pride. Once he was sick, he didn't really want to see anyone.
Yeah, he was always doing a lot. You know, it must have been really tough for him. So what's this about Jason?
My husband came home 2 days ago from a two-week-long business trip, and I woke up the next morning, and he was gone.
Gone?
Yeah, it's been 24 hours and no phone call, no text, nothing.
Well, that's strange. Has he ever done this before?
I mean, he leaves for work a lot. You know, I don't know, maybe he went on another trip and didn't tell me.
Did you start calling his family? Brother, sister, parents?
He doesn't really have any family. His parents died before we got married. He's got a sister, but she's a bit of a recluse. I've never even met her.
Yeah, sorry about that. What about his friends?
Called some of them. I don't know, he works a lot. He doesn't really have a lot of friends up here in Big Bear.
Work?
I called his work, and they actually told me that he didn't work there.
I'll put a tag in the system, and that'll let us know if anything shows up. And I'll make some phone calls. Here, let me give you my card. And you call me if he shows up. All right? Or if you need anything.
I will. I appreciate it. Thank you. It's good to see you.
You too. Sorry. It was under these circumstances.
Me too.
It's Sarah. I know we haven't talked in a really long time, but... Oh, no, yes, you know me. I'm Jason's wife. I'm pretty certain I have the right number. Jason said that... Right. Yes, of course, I'm sorry, I won't bother you again.
Hi.
Thank you for coming over.
Yeah. Not a problem. This is my partner, Detective Miller.
Hi, how are you?
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you. Wow. Wow, this is really something.
Thank you.
Sarah and I go way back. Her father and I were once partners back in the old L.A. Police Department days.
Yeah, he talked a lot about those days.
That was a long time ago.
Wow. Some view.
Thank you.
So, Mr. Goodman's been missing for almost 40 hours, is that correct?
Yeah, I think so. I'm not sure exactly what time he left the house.
Any of his personal belongings gone? Clothing, toothbrush?
I don't think so, no.
What about the bank accounts? Have you checked them lately?
No. Why would I do that?
How's your relationship with your husband?
It's perfect. Why?
Did you and Jason ever fight?
No. I mean, we have disagreements, but we don't ever fight.
So your relationship is always good and you've never gone through any rough patches.
I'm sorry, Daniel. What are you trying to insinuate here?
Mrs. Goodman, 90% of disappearances are due to arguments about money, family, maybe an affair.
My husband is not having an affair.
I didn't say that he was.
We're just trying to get a sense of whether...
Whether my husband and I secretly hate each other or not?
I didn't say that.
Well, that's what you're implying, right? Are you thinking that I did something to my husband?
We didn't say that. Please don't get excited.
I love my husband. Jason and Brandon are they're my entire world. And my husband is out there missing, and you're making these accusations as if something evil is going on.
Ma'am, we're just trying to get a feeling of the dynamic between you and Mr. Goodman. Look, unfortunately, people, they don't just disappear. There's always a reason. Now, it would be unwise if we didn't ask certain questions to get a sense.
Why don't you call a psychic?
Sarah, we're here to help you.
Well, it feels like you're here to accuse me. I don't know why you're not out on the streets looking for him.
We have other officers doing that right now.
No, you don't. And don't patronize me.
Sarah, we're not patronizing you. Why don't we start again?
Fine. Then why don't you start by searching my house? Maybe you'll find something that I haven't.
That's not necessary.
Well, not right now, but...
Then get out there and go look for him.
I'm sorry, Sarah. Maybe we handled this improperly.
Yeah. Me too.
I promise we will make every effort to find Jason.
You know, actions speak louder than words, Daniel.
Yes. They do.
Well, it's definitely odd for a husband not to contact his wife in 36 hours.
A laundry list of things could have happened to him. He could have driven his car off the road somewhere. Business deal gone wrong. Heart attack.
Yeah, possibly. But I'm leaning on the side of a domestic issue.
Well, you know her. You think she's capable of doing anything criminal?
If I've learned anything through these years, everyone is capable.
Right.
That's what I do. Babe. just nothing to worry about.
I'm sorry, Sarah. Unfortunately, you're not a match. We need to find your husband.
Isn't there another option?
We should test every member of your family, but since you're not a match, the odds of anyone else in your family being a match are slim. Additionally, finding a match from the general population are slim as well. Now, Brandon is already on the list, and if anyone is the right match, they'll notify me immediately. In the meantime, let's pray your husband shows up.
When exactly does this become critical for Brandon?
We can stave the disease off with medicine for a year, maybe even two or three,
but what?
His health will deteriorate without the transplant.
Sorry.
I'm sorry, sir.
Okay, so you're telling me there's been no activity on this cell phone since the 17th?
Nothing.
You're sure?
I'm sorry, ma'am. It's very clear on my screen. That phone has not been used since the night of the 17th.
Okay. Thank you for checking.
Have a good night.
I'm sorry, but we need to search the property again.
Daniel, really? You've searched it twice. Isn't that enough?
It's been a month with no sign of your husband. And our entire town and our entire police force and the FBI have been searching and have come up with nothing until now. We have some new leads that we could simply clear up if we could just come in and search.
Can't you see how upsetting this is?
We found a woman that we believe Jason was having an intimate affair with.
No, that's a lie.
It's just some investigating to do. But the evidence corroborates the fact. Is this yours?
I haven't seen that in years. Where did you find that?
We found it on the woman.
What does that mean, you found it on the woman?
We found it on her dead body. Your fingerprints are on it.
Daniel, of course my fingerprints are on it. It's mine. Jason gave it to me on our anniversary. I know that it's mine because there's a stone missing by the clasp. She could have found that anywhere.
Do you know her?
No.
Her name is Amanda Woodward.
Well, I've never seen her before in my entire life. How did she die?
It's not important. What is important is the department is gathering evidence right now and a cause for motive. And at this very moment, honestly, our only probable suspects are Jason and you.
Oh my God, Daniel. Come on, I didn't kill anyone. It's insane for you to think that I did.
That's why I'm asking you to please let us in again so we can make sure there's no connection between you and Amanda Woodward.
Can't you see how insulting and painful it is to be accused of something so horrific?
I can't even imagine what you're going through.
You can't imagine.
I am truly sorry.
I have nothing to hide. My home is yours.
All right. Okay. Please be respectful of her home.
but usually late at night. I'll put this in his box, and I'm sure he'll be by tonight. No worries.
Great. Thank you so much.
Have a good one.
You too. Thanks.
Okay?
Go to bed. I love you. I'll be back soon.
No!
Put Aunt Lauren on the phone, please. Hey. Look, I need to stay here a little bit longer. I'm sorry he's being difficult for you. Just try to calm him down and just get him to bed.
I will. Don't worry about it. You just... do what you need to do.
I owe you big time.
How can I help you?
Hi, I'm a broker with Superior Realty, and periodically I knock on the doors of the beautiful homes in the area and try to talk to the owners about selling. I think your house is gorgeous, and I'm sure you could make a lot of money on the sale. I'm Allison Shaw.
Oh, hi, Allison. I'm Emily.
Emily
Marcus.
Marcus. Right. It's funny, I don't know any Marcuses in the area.
We've lived here a long time. We pretty much know everyone in the neighborhood.
Well, I'm fairly new, so it's nice to make a new friend.
I'm so sorry, I'm being rude. Would you like to come in and see the house?
I would love to. Thank you.
Come on in. Sorry, the door always does that.
It's okay.
So this is the entryway to the home, which I think is the most important part of the home, really.
Is this your family?
Yes. We have three children. Richard, 18, he's a freshman at UCLA. And Jenny is a senior in high school, and my youngest, Katie, is 13.
You have a beautiful family.
Thank you. So, the kitchen is this way. My husband, David, actually wanted another, but he worked so much, I told him to find a job where he could work at home since he's gone so much.
What does your husband do?
He's in pharmaceuticals.
Right, of course.
What does that mean?
Nothing. Well, pharmaceuticals, very lucrative business, and clearly, your husband does really well.
Yeah, it's a trade-off, though. Sometimes I wish we were broke and he would stay home full-time.
I get that.
Well, anyway, this is the kitchen, and we remodeled it about 2.5 years ago. Stainless steel appliances, all brand new, all beautiful, every amenity you could think of. And then this here is the family room. And I think as you step up here, you can tell it's completely soundproof. The perfect room to sit down with your family and watch movies. And believe me, we've seen them all. A beautiful fireplace, just perfect nights in here, you know?
Yeah.
And then this is the dining room. It's really the heart of the house. I mean, we've had so many incredible dinners here with the family. It'd be hard to part with, but... this is the living room. Probably something I'm proudest of.
I'm sorry.
Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm fine. I've seen a lot of houses this week. I think I'm worn down.
You want a glass of water?
I would love a glass of water, yeah.
Okay.
Thank you. I'll just leave it here on the table.
Thanks.
Thank you.
Room temperature. What do you think about the living room?
David.
No.
David!
Jason.
You need to talk to her.
She left me alone.
Ow! Jason!
What is going on?
She's a crook. I caught her trying to steal this.
That's my grandmother's.
Exactly. You let her into our house.
Oh my God. Completely fell for it. How could you do something like this? I'm calling the police.
No, no, no. I think she's learned her lesson.
You need to get out of here right now. Not only did you try to steal from me, but you made me look like a fool.
Jason, just do this for Brandon.
Please. He needs you. Who is Brandon?
This woman is certifiable. You can't believe a word she says. You're lucky I came home when I did.
You need to
rethink your attitude!
No, that won't be necessary.
Why?
Because I have other plans.
What does that mean?
Listen, Sarah, I'm sorry, okay? We had a great time together, but it's just not rational to have two families. So one of them has to go.
Jason, you're insane. Jason? Jason! Stress seems to be affecting him. He looks like he's gotten worse.
Don't worry. The police are going to track Jason down tonight, and they will force him to give the bone marrow.
I'm losing faith in the police. Plus, they can't force him to do anything.
Well, if they don't, I will.
Well, we can't run the risk of the police hurting him either. I need to just take care of this by myself.
How are you gonna do that?
I'm gonna be the bait.
No, Sarah, you cannot do that.
What choice do I have?
David.
I just wanted to tell you that I love you.
And I love you.
I haven't been honest with you.
What are you talking about?
I have two wives, okay? I have two families.
How can that be?
It doesn't matter how. What matters is that after tonight, there will only be one family.
What are you talking about?
It means that after tonight, they will be gone. They will be erased.
You can't just erase people.
I can, and I will.
David, stop it.
I'm gonna fix the problem.
What is your emergency?
I think my husband's gonna do something bad.
Is she okay?
We gotta get to her house.
Let's go. looking for something. You didn't answer my question. Are you looking for something?
Hello, Jason. There's a David.
Is this what you're looking for? Sure it is. You know, honey, you really have no loyalty.
Don't talk to me about loyalty. You abandoned us, remember? You're nothing to me. You're a lying bastard.
Which is exactly why I have to get rid of some dead weight.
Okay, you don't care about me. What about Brandon?
Why should I care about Brandon? It was your mistake. I could have left you the day you told me you were pregnant with him, but I didn't. I stayed. I played the husband. Played the father. Even with a whole other family to take care of.
No, you're lying. I've seen you with Brandon. You love him.
No. No, I don't. That part of me is dead now. I love Emily, not you.
You're insane.
It's not nice. Oh, and by the way, don't go out front looking for those cops. They killed them. They're dead.
Just kill me.
No, not yet.
Why?
Because I need you. I need you to get to Brandon. Then I'll kill you. Okay, so where is he? Is he at Lawrence? Is that where he is?